At the age of 24, in 1848, Edward Austin Sheldon, a resident of SUNY Oswego, wanted to study somewhat into the condition of the poor of that city. To embark on his journey, Sheldon sought the aid of influential friends and formed the Orphan and Free School Association. Sheldon found that he must teach the school or the enterprise would be abandoned, and requested $200 as a salary to sustain his living. Instead, he received $300. And in the basement of an old church, the inexperienced young teacher was brought face to face with 120 boys and girls from 5 to 21. From this movement sprang the Free and Graded Schools of Oswego, which were organized by Mr. Sheldon in 1853. As superintendent of the school, he grew dissatisfied with his work. However, after visiting Toronto, he saw in the National Museum a collection of appliances used abroad, things such as pictures of animals, samples of grain, books, and etc. In 1859, a new course for the primary schools was introduced at Oswego. It taught on form, color, size, the human body, plants, and more. But then, he was faced with the issue of his teachers not having enough knowledge on the lessons and had to become the teacher and the trainer of his teachers. Given the inadequacy of his teaching, he obtained a training teacher who would educate him and his most interested teachers on the material. This continued for 2 years, and in 1863, it was adopted by the state and granted $3,000. This would mark the beginning of what was known as the Oswego Normal School.